want to thank you all for this opportunity. 4 months ago, October of 2008, I stood in the courtyard behind us after the grand jury indicted Casey Anthony for the murder of her daughter, and I said that we would not discuss this case outside of the courtroom, and I am pleased to say that we have not until this time. At that time, I also said that the indictment was not a conviction and that the defendant is always cloaked with a presumption of innocence. I promised that we would do our talking in court. We did. For us, the case has never been about the defendant in particular. It has always been about seeking justice for Kaylee and speaking on her behalf. Some have exploited the case for personal gain, ad revenues, or 15 minutes of fame. And since day one, we have kept our promise that we would be focusing on finding and proving the truth about this child's homicide. The pretrial publicity generated by others has led to the great expense of having to seek a jury outside of our media market. We have avoided making any statements that would feed the publicity and have only released what Florida public records law requires us to release. That is whatever documents we furnish in discovery. So much of the angst and taxpayer expense in this case could have been avoided if others had not succumbed to the temptation provided by quick notoriety. We think that justice is best served when counsel does not render public opinions on matters of litigation. We have always tried to prevent the issuance of any statements that were not relevant, and that all relevant statements be made in the courtroom. There are a number of professional, dedicated, and talented people who persevered to bring this case to its conclusion. Linda Drain Burdick led the team with great skill and energy. Jeff Ashton built a precision forensic case, and Frank George presented a series of complex witnesses. This trial team is world-class and in command of the evidence. They did it skillfully and without histrionics. I'd like to thank the jury for their contribution to justice. The task they were asked to complete was difficult, and this community owes them a debt of gratitude. Ours is a fact-driven process, and we've had a lot of help gathering the facts. The lead agency in this case has been the Orange County Sheriff's Office. Sheriff Jerry Demings has led a great team, a team I shall forever be proud of, and I want to thank him very personally for the excellent work that he and his department have done in order to bring this case together. And at this time, I would like to ask Sheriff Demings to make a few remarks.
Good afternoon. It is my duty and privilege to stand before you this afternoon to make a few brief comments as we have now come to the close of the murder trial involving Casey Marie Anthony. I must acknowledge my investigative team who stands with me this afternoon. As we have just celebrated the 4th of July, Independence Day, we celebrate the United States of America and what freedom means to each of us. We must remember that men and women have died in our armed forces and law enforcement to protect the rights of others like us who value freedom, independence, and life. For 3 long years, the citizens of Orange County have sought justice in the death of 2-year-old Kaylee Marie Anthony. On December 11th, 2008, Kaylee's remains were discovered. The Orange County Sheriff's Office has been involved in the criminal investigation of her disappearance and death since July of 2008. There have been numerous individuals and agencies that have assisted us during the investigation and prosecution case of Casey Marie Anthony. I must acknowledge a few of those individuals and agencies who have assisted us today. There have been numerous volunteers who assisted in the search for Kaylee. I must thank the Orlando Police Department, the Orange County Medical Examiner, the Orange County Corrections Department, the Florida Department of Law Enforcement, the Federal Bureau of Investigation, the State Attorney's Office for the 9th Judicial Circuit here in Florida. I must also thank personally State Attorney Lawson Lamar and his team of prosecutors, especially attorneys Jeffrey Ashton and Linda Drain Burdick, for the thorough, vigorous, and complete prosecution in this case. I must also thank my deputy sheriffs, detectives, forensics, and other support personnel who worked diligently to assemble the evidence to conclude this death investigation. I could not be any more proud of the performance of my staff throughout both the investigation and the trial. They have admirably represented the Orange County Sheriff's Office and citizens of Orange County, Florida, throughout the process. Now, I must also recognize the support shown to the Orange County Sheriff's Office by both the community and the media throughout the proceedings. On behalf of the nearly 2,500 men and women of the Orange County Sheriff's Office, we thank you for your support. As the verdict has been rendered, we ask our community to respect the decision the jury and court have made today. In doing so, we ask for your continued peaceful acknowledgement of that verdict. Historically, there have been other high-profile criminal prosecutions throughout our nation that resulted in civil disobedience. Please, I ask this community that regardless of one's personal beliefs about the innocence or guilt of Casey Marie Anthony, that you maintain your peaceful resolve. I also ask that those who do not live in the Anthony's neighborhood, they're off Hope Springs Drive, to avoid that area. Deputy sheriffs will be patrolling throughout the county to ensure that order and peace is maintained. Again, I thank the Honorable Lawson L. Lamar for his support, and I turn it back over to him this afternoon.
Thank you, Sheriff. We are grateful to the attorneys and staff who put this case on. All of you saw that Linda Drain Burdick brought together a precision case. Jeff Ashton presented wonderful scientific evidence and rebutted a lot of scientific evidence with extreme skill. Frank George presented a series of complex witnesses, and we owe them a lot. Their staff backed them the whole way. The Orange County Grand Jury of spring term 2008 provided this indictment, and we thank them for their work. We have a world-class medical examiner's office and staff here, and Dr. Jan Garavaglia did her usual wonderful work. And I want to personally reiterate thanks to Sheriff's personnel Yuri Melich, John Allen, Eric Edwards. The FBI, their laboratory people, did work that was not only relevant in each and every case, but excellent. I want to thank Special Agent Nick Savage, Karen Cowan, and Paula Wolf, their general counsel. I want to thank Texas EquiSearch and the thousands of volunteers who searched for Kaylee Marie Anthony. The Florida Department of Law Enforcement, their laboratories did extremely fine work for all of us as citizens. The Pinellas County State Attorney, Bernie McCabe, and his staff helped us. Arpad Voss of the Oak Ridge National Laboratory did amazing work. We're proud of all of them. And you need to realize that tomorrow, my homicide teams will go back to work like they do every day in an attempt to find justice for the other approximately 140 pending murder cases in Orange County, 11 of which are children. Child murders, regretfully and terribly, are not rare in America today. And those deaths are no less horrible and needless than that suffered by Kaylee Anthony. The only difference has been that the news has not highlighted their murders. We do this business of seeking justice each and every day, protecting the innocent from criminals. That's what prosecutors do. We're disappointed with the verdict today and surprised because we know the facts and we put in absolutely every piece of evidence that existed. Our team did an exemplary job. I'm proud of them and I stand by their work. I never, ever criticize a jury. Theirs is the task of deciding what to believe. Reasonable doubt as to each and every element in a case, especially a case like this, which is a mosaic of proof with no smoking gun and a tiny victim who is reduced by time and the elements to skeletal remains, those remains lacking in any chemical evidence that could be brought forward. This was a dry bones case, very, very difficult to prove. The delay in recovering little Kaylee's remains worked to our considerable disadvantage. Our mountain of evidence did not eliminate, in the jury's view, every reasonable doubt. The investigators, the scientists, and the prosecutors did their job. So did the jury. We do not criticize them. So did the defense. They did a good job. We go back to work tomorrow to prosecute the 101,000 cases that come to us each year, the 140 pending murders, and the 11 remaining child murders. We thank you for your attention. We thank the public for their attention to this case. And I would reiterate the request that Sheriff Demings made for calm in the public. Despite what your personal view as to guilt or innocence might be, the criminal justice system has worked. We did our job. The jury did their job. The court was extremely well managed. And this is justice in America. We go forward to fight again tomorrow with great thanks to all the people that have helped us do our duty. This concludes the presentation. Thank you.